Hi, we're here at the Intel Innovation 2023, and I'm excited to be able to present a demo today that's the world's first PCI 6 interop between Synopsys and Intel's Gen 6 test chip. So let's take a look at what we've got. Here, looking at the hardware, at the bottom is the Intel Gen 6 test chip platform here, this entire circuit board, and here, the device, this is the actual test chip. So what we're going to do is take information from this board through this device, which is the Teledyne LaCroix interposer that can capture the data, can capture the information, and we're going to look at that a little bit later. And then it goes to the Synopsys daughter card that has the Synopsys Gen 6 PHY in a test chip right over here. Then these green cables you see are connecting the pipe interface that's in the FPGA on this daughter card over here to this box, which is the HAPS 100 prototyping system that contains an FPGA implementation of our PCI 6.0 controller configured as an endpoint. So this, together with this, represents a complete endpoint system, and then it's talking to the Intel Gen 6 PHY test chip with the Teledyne LaCroix interposer listening in for the conversation, so to speak. So what we're seeing here in the demo that's happening live right now is we're doing speed changes to show the robustness of the link. So you're seeing here the speed was Gen 4, it changed to Gen 3, then Gen 3 to Gen 2, and it's continuously doing this. And you can see we've been running this for quite a while now. We're at 6,000 some consecutive speed changes without ever having to go to recovery or start the link up over again. So this is really great. It's a great robust link. This is the Intel side looking at it from the host perspective. On the device side, looking at the Synopsys interface, this is our Voyager GUI, and we're showing kind of the same thing. They're a little bit out of sync, but you can see the speed changing here. Right now we're at 16 gig or Gen 4 speed. We're always at one lane. Now we're at 32 gig, and you'll see we're in flip mode. Some folks don't realize, but since the Gen 6 spec came along, once you negotiate that 64 gig link for Gen 6 speed, you have to stay in flip mode. That's a flip mode requirement. So even when we drop down to 32 gig, 5 gig, 8 gig, whatever it may be, we still have to stay in flip mode, and that's what you're seeing right here. So now, what's happening with the interposer card and the Teledyne LaCroix IP? We're capturing this information, and that's shown over here. So there's a lot of detail here, and I'm not going to go into it all, but basically what we're seeing is a record of the speed change negotiations. We captured this during some of the speed changes, and you're seeing some idle flits here because we don't have a controller on the Intel side. We can't actually send TLP, so we're just sending, in that case, idle flits. We're doing the speed changes and the equalization steps. And so all that's shown here, and then we've just popped up on the screen this LTSSM flow-through graph showing the different stages where we go from detect to polling, configuration L0, and if we wanted to, we could push down into any one of these, and you can see all the details of each of the flits. So, if you wanted to push down into the recovery speed, for example, here, you know, suddenly now you can see all this data here. And this is a great tool to debug a new protocol like Gen 6. And in our case, it's just kind of another level where we're showing the robustness of the demo. We're showing the actual steps that are happening in there. So that's it for this demo. Thanks for watching.